Hi guys, FatsoGamer here. Today I'm going to be playing Batman Arkham Asylum. This game is by Rocksteady and is the first in the series of the Batman games. Okay, let's get into it. So, this game basically has you playing as Batman. And you're taking the Joker to Arkham Asylum. However, what happens along the way, he gets out. He starts making a bit of mayhem at the asylum, letting other inmates out. You've got to sort of try and catch him. Now, what I'm actually playing now is a challenge mode in it. I didn't want to give away any of the story. So rather than playing the main game that I've got saved, I thought I'd just show you this. Now, the story in this is extremely engrossing. It's something where you actually feel like you're Batman. The voice acting's on point, especially from the Joker and Batman, really adds a different element to it. Even things like the cutscenes. So the cutscenes in this are something that, like, normally I'm someone that skips the cutscenes because I just want to play the game. I'm not really fascinated or interested by the story. With this game, however, I was just all over it. I was actually, you know, sitting back, putting the controller down and listening to the story unfold because it's actually got a lot of depth in it. Even once you've finished the story mode, there's things like these challenge modes to do. So, you know, there's always a little bit more to do. In regards to the actual gameplay itself, so it is very, like, you just follow the bouncing ball, so you basically go from point A to point B to point C to point D, and it flows very naturally. So it's not something where you're sort of wandering around and wondering what to do. You've always got something to do. It's always engaging and exciting, and really, as I said before, draws you in. Now, the next thing I'll go through in this is the combat. So the combat system in this is extremely simple. Basically, when they've got the blue lines over their heads, you can counter. And then you've got your attack buttons as well. So you can build up a bit of a combo with these. And you can even add in things like gadgets as well, once you sort of unlock them and get a bit more proficient with them. With that though, the combat system is not only limited to just sort of raking havoc with your fists and your feet, you've also got stealth that you can use. So there's occasions where, you know, you'll have to go through air vents in order to sort of get past enemies and behind them and take them down quietly, or you might have to hide be above gargoyles and take them down from up above. There's, you know, you can either play it with stealth or you can just go all out and sort of go nuts. The thing that I really like about it too is he is true, well, the character is true to Batman. He never kills anyone, so he always knocks them out. So the difficulty then comes when the enemies start getting guns. Basically, you've got to try and knock them out and take them down without killing them while they're shooting you with machine guns and things. So definitely challenging, definitely, you know, makes you sort of use all your skill sets in the combos. With the combos as well, you actually get experience points as you progress, and those experience points can be used to upgrade your armor. You can also upgrade your gadgets as well. And you can even upgrade your moves. So you'll unlock different moves as you go along as well, which you can also add into your repertoire. So it's something that gives you longevity, makes you want to progress so that you can see more moves. You can, you know, kick a bit further. You can add extra things in. You get extra batarangs and things like that. And as you're progressing through the game as well, there's all these hidden items. So you've got Riddler trophies. Now, these trophies aren't things where, oh, look, there's one in the corner, I'll pick it up. Usually they're hidden in a room and you've got to sort of figure out a way to get in there. So you might have to break through a wall or come in through the roof or use one of your gadgets to decode a security gate. So, and it adds a new element because you can quite easily see them in each room, but then it's like, oh, how do I get in there? How do I get past this? Yeah, something that's not tedious either. It's not like, oh, I've got to collect all these, you know, stupid things for my, percentage completion. It's something that you actually enjoy doing. The other thing you'll pick up through the game as well is these little, like, recording tapes, and they'll give you session notes. So, like, you'll pick up ones from, like, all the villains. So, like, Harley Quinn, the Joker, you know, Two-Face. And it'll sort of give you more information of their backstory and how they came to be in the asylum. really, really interesting, great to listen to. And again, you want to collect them because you want to unfold more of the story. So you can probably already tell this is a game that I'm going to recommend. It's something that I really enjoy. It's actually the reason, the sole reason I bought an Xbox One. I basically completed all these games, so the Rocksteady ones, so this and Arkham City, and I wanted to get Arkham Knight just so I could, you know, experience the last part of the chapter, which Rocksteady did. There was another developer that had a foray in this series, which was the Origins one, but that's not quite as good. So I may do that in another review, I may not, but just know that Arkham Asylum is where you should start with this series. Arkham City is very good, and Arkham Knight is good. However, there is some tedium with the Batmobile, but you can sort of get past this. So look, guys, if you haven't played any of these Batman series, I highly recommend you pick it up. Just remember always to look for Rocksteady. Basically, Origins is the only one that doesn't do it. There is a Telltale series on Xbox One, which I haven't played, but I can tell you the gameplay, the story, the combat, the unlockables, everything with Rocksteady is rock solid. So highly recommend. I hope you can pick it up. Hey guys, thanks for watching Fatso Gamer. Please hit like and subscribe, and I will see you on the next video.